Hello, Bea here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. As you can see, I'm currently trying to shelter from a major lightning storm outside. It keeps lighting up the sky and booming all around me. Yikes! In today's lesson, we'll solve the mystery of what causes lightning and find out if I'm currently in any danger from it. It all has to do with one of the forms of energy you learned about in the previous unit. Electricity. Hopefully I don't get zapped first, though. But before we bolt through this lesson, let's look at our goals. By the end, you'll be able to explain the rules of attraction and repulsion in static electricity, and explain how electrical charges and static electricity cause lightning. Before we can understand lightning, we have to know about electrical charge. And to understand electrical charge, we'll have to revisit a topic we learned about way back at the beginning of this course. Do you remember learning about the parts of an atom? We learned that protons and neutrons make up the nucleus, while the electrons go zipping around the outside. Which of these particles do you think are involved directly in electricity? Do their names give you any clues? Electricity definitely involves electrons. And what charge do electrons have? Negative. Remember that protons have positive charge and neutrons are neutral with no charge. While we often just describe charges as positive or negative, charge is actually a quantitative property, meaning it can be assigned a numerical value. But anytime we measure something with a number, what else is needed? A unit. Numbers always need units, or they don't mean anything. Charge is often measured in a unit called coulombs. The charge in coulombs on a single electron is tiny, 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19th. In standard form, there would be 18 zeros after the decimal before our first digit. But remember, an electron is unimaginably small. That lightning bolt that almost got me earlier probably had at least 20 coulombs of charge. So a single coulomb is a fairly significant amount of charge. But what exactly is static electricity, and why does it make your hair stand up? Remember we said earlier that charges can be either positive or negative. A fundamental law of the universe is that like charges repel, while opposite charges attract. Have you ever played with magnets? If so, you may be aware that if you bring two north ends together, they repel or push apart. But if you flip one magnet such that a north end is brought near a south end, they attract or pull toward each other. Electrical charges work in the exact same way. Two like charges, such as two protons or two electrons, will repel each other, while opposite charges, such as a proton and electron together, will attract. In fact, spoiler alert, we'll find out in an upcoming lesson on magnets that their north and south poles are caused by the behavior of electrons as well. A great example of static electricity can be seen when rubbing a balloon against the fur of this cat. As the balloon is rubbed against the fur, friction causes the negative charges in the balloon to gather near the bottom, or point of contact. The negative charges attract the positive charges in the cat's fur. This forced separation of charges is known as induction. Now that the cat's fur has all positive charges in it, the individual pieces of fur repel each other, but attract to the negatively charged balloon. This causes the cat's fur to stand up. Of course, it doesn't only work on cats. Grab a balloon and you can do the same thing to your own hair. In the lesson PDF activities, you'll explore this phenomenon further and find out which materials are capable of producing static electricity and why. For now, know that static electricity exists anytime we have positive and negative charges, which are really just protons and electrons. These charges will always obey nature's rule about attracting and repelling. Does this mean there are charges in the lightning that's still going on outside? And could those charges have something to do with how angry the sky seems to be right now? Let's find out! Now that we understand electric charge, let's look at how these charges can cause lightning. Similar to how the positive charges gather in the balloon, the negative charges tend to gather at the bottom of a cloud during a storm, while the positive charges gather at the top. The reason for this involves chemical and physical interactions that we won't delve into in this course, but this is the outcome. This induces a positive charge near the surface of the ground, as the positive charges already in the ground are attracted to the negative charges in the bottom of the cloud. When the attraction between these positive and negative charges becomes strong enough, a massive transfer of negative charges or electrons takes place between the cloud and ground, which we see as lightning. So, is the light you see and the sound you hear the actual transfer of electrical charges? Not quite, but the light and sound is a direct result of it. The rapid transfer of electrical energy causes the air nearby to heat up by thousands of degrees. This quick burst of heat produces the light you see. When air heats up, it also expands or spreads out, but the heat doesn't last long at all. And within milliseconds, it has dissipated, causing the air to quickly cool and contract down again. This collapsing air causes the loud boom that you hear as thunder. So, what do we think? Am I safe here? What would happen if lightning hit me? Well, it would send a massive transfer of charge through my body as the charges passed to the ground. This would likely disrupt the electrical signals my brain sends to my heart, causing it to stop. And of course, there's the issue of the rapidly increasing temperature in the vicinity of the lightning bolt. My body probably wouldn't survive that either. So when lightning is nearby, it's best to stay inside or at least under some type of shelter. And if you notice this happening on your arms, it means charges are already building up around you, a definite sign that you may be in lightning's immediate path. So get inside quickly. As we went through the lesson today, we saw that electricity is fundamentally about charges, specifically the negative charges known as electrons. The charges will always repel other electrons, but attract positive charges known as protons. When there is a strong enough attraction between positive and negative charges, lightning can occur. On a much smaller scale, you may have experienced this transfer of charge when getting shocked by something. When are you most likely to get shocked? Maybe after rubbing your feet on the carpet? Just like rubbing a balloon on your hair, this friction causes the charges in your skin to separate, and that sets the stage for a rapid transfer of charge when you touch something metal. We'll learn more about which materials can transmit this charge as we go through the unit. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. Hey, hey. See you next time.